what I do.
Hey, what are the three biggest mistakes that I'm seeing sellers make in this market? What's up, everybody? It's John Wentworth, Wentworth Real Estate Group. And I got to share this with you because it's super important if you're going to sell a home in 2021. So I'm going to share with you the three biggest mistakes that I'm seeing sellers make, even in this wonderful market. So here they are. And too fast, for sale by owner, and just thinking you can hire anyone. So the biggest mistake that I'm seeing is accepting an offer too quickly. And you might think, but John, I got an offer right away. Okay, great. Not so great if you're accepting that offer right away. Now, could there be times when I would encourage one of my sellers? Sure. If it were way over list price, if it were cash, no inspection, no appraisal, then I might say, hey guys, maybe we should consider this. But it used to be in real estate, you would hear people say, well, your first offer is usually your best, which is just some silly term realtors would use. The truth is right now, the first offer is probably not your best. Accepting an offer too quickly. We're seeing this often. I mentioned this last week. I watch this inside of our office. Our agents will schedule showings on homes that just hit the market. And they'll fly out the door, and by the time they get there, that seller, per that agent, has accepted another offer. And we all just scratch our head thinking, gosh, how much money did they leave on the table? You gotta understand how strong this market is, right? And you have to have a strategy that will also take the masses of people and get them through your door in a short period of time, right? That takes marketing and that takes a strategy, which is why we excel at it. But a realtor jumping around, high-fiving their seller that they sold the house in 1 hour is really, it's just not great representation. That's called emotion, right? That's not called negotiating. That's called emotional woo-hoo is what I call it. And it's costing sellers money. So number one, accepting an offer too quickly. As I said, sure, sometimes there are times that you may look at that, but boy, that offer better be ironclad and it better be super strong as far as price. Number two, FSBO, right? Now I know you're gonna say, yeah, John, sure, you don't want us to sell for sale by owner because then you wouldn't get a commission. And here's what I would share with you to combat that, because people ask this all the time, right? First of all, you're talking about a 6% commission. You cut that in half because if you're gonna list your home by owner, you're still gonna end up paying more than likely the buyer's agent, so that's 3%. So really, we're talking about saving 3%, okay? Let's talk about what 3% is. Think about a $500,000 home, 3%, 15 grand. Seems like a lot of money, doesn't it? Except I just hung up the phone with the seller who thought their home was worth $490,000 because that's what Zillow told them, and it's worth $650,000. That 3% probably wouldn't have done them much good, right? Here's the second point to that, though. If you think by putting one of those red and white silly signs in your yard and telling a few of your friends about your home being for sale and procuring, actually, like someone knocks on your door and says, yeah, I'll buy it. If you think that that zero marketing can produce one buyer, don't you think that a real marketing plan and a real strategy can create multiple, thus driving the price up? So again, we're going back to talking about 3%. And in this market, I can almost assure you, you're leaving money on the table. So you're leaving money on the table if you're accepting the offer too quickly, and you're probably leaving money on the table if you're selling for sale by owner, because there just is no massive marketing, and there certainly is no strategy to make sure that, listen, every home that comes on the market right now has several buyers just waiting to go in it. And so you think that the first one comes along as your best offer when there's another one? I'm out of pens right now, but there's another one, and then there's another buyer, and then there's another buyer, and then there's another buyer, and they're all waiting to get in the door, but you took the first offer. Probably not a good idea. And then here's the third thing. Believing that because the market is so strong, well, I can just hire anyone. Well, here's what I would say to that. Right now, more than ever, because the market is so strong, you need the strongest realtor you've ever had. Because anybody can put a home on the MLS for 200 grand or 500 grand or whatever it's worth and sell it. My son, Rocco, he's 10. Or no, he's 11. Dahlia's 10. He can put a home in the MLS. Like, he can peck it away. I can show him how to do it and put one photo of the damn thing and sell it. That doesn't mean he sold it for the most money. Right? So I think that's the number one, in a hiring process, the biggest mistake is, well, we're just going to hire anybody because the market's so strong. Well, how is that anybody that hasn't sold much real estate going to negotiate when there's 15 offers on the table, right? Or how are they even going to have a strategy in place to create those 15 offers? And then once you have those offers, how do you make sure that you structure the contract that is ironclad for the seller, right? Because everybody gets all happy and woohoo and high five over the fact that they have a piece of paper. I have a, you know, a piece of paper that says I sold my home, but that piece of paper means nothing if it doesn't make it to the closing table. So right now, the terms inside of a contract are ultra important. People, buyers, are doing whatever it takes to get a home under contract. Then guess what happens? They start, not all of them, some of them start to do whatever they can to get the price down after the negotiation. You say, well, how? Well, inspection, appraisal, survey issues, whatever it may be. So this contract that you enter has to be so ironclad that it's basically a check getting ready to be cashed. Those are the three things, guys, and it's super important. So if you know somebody looking to sell this year, just share this video with them. I don't care who they call. Just make sure they call a pro, not a Joe. So this is Pros versus Joe, number one. Make sure you're sharing this with your friends and family if they're going to sell a home, okay? Make sure that you're giving them the opportunity to understand why these things are important so that they can hire a pro and not a Joe. And again, I don't care. Don't call me. That's fine. I mean, please do call me. But at the same time, you know, we've got a lot of seasoned senior list agents. And yeah, there's a difference between a list agent and a buy agent. And that's what I'm going to cover in the next video tomorrow. So with that, those are my three things. People are accepting offers too quickly because there's no plan in place. There's no strategy behind what they're doing. For sale by owners are costing themselves money, I believe, now more than ever. And it's just true. And then the third thing, you know, believing that because the market's strong, I can just hire anybody. But you can't. Now more than ever, you've got to hire the best. For marketing, for strategy, for negotiating, and for getting you to the closing table. That's it. You guys have a wonderful day. Peace out.